This might not look much, but this is the beginning of a big project, and that project is going to be an electric scooter. And the idea is that there are two wheels that are driven by 8 motors, and those motors are hidden inside the wheels. So this is the beginning, and let's see how it goes onwards. So here is the progress report. When I first show you the way the motors were placed and the gear inside, I actually put the wrong gear. It's supposed to be a 20 tooth gear, not a 12 tooth gear, when the one I put in the middle of the motors. I quickly found the issue and corrected it. And that gear is driving the yellow 28 tooth gear, as you can see just barely here. And that 28 tooth gear is driving two 12 tooth gears. And those are driving these green gears. And those green gears will be driving the wheels that are, the gears that are actually driving the wheels. So in total, there should be 8 gears that are driving each wheel, and all the other gears that are gonna be interacting with the wheel are idle gears to basically help carry the load. So here's the progress so far, and it's not long now. I still need to install 4 more motors and lots of gears. So another progress update, and I built this part of the hub assembly so you can see better how the gearing works. So basically the motors are driving this central shaft. All 8 motors are gonna be driving the same axle. And this axle drives a 20 tooth gear, which is driving this 28 tooth gear. And behind this 28 tooth gear is a 12 tooth gear. And this 12 tooth gear is driving this clutch 20 tooth gear. And finally this 20 tooth clutch gear is the one that is gonna actually be driving the wheel. And the 24 tooth gears here at the side and more here are all gonna be supporting the wheel while it's spinning around. Of course, all the moving parts have been lubricated, so to prevent the unnecessary wear and tear and to decrease friction of the whole hub. So the core of the wheel hub has been finished, and I'm just gonna emphasize again what it does. First, there are 8 motors integrated inside the hub. So 8 BuWizz motors, and there's a whole gearbox inside. So we have down gearing of 20 to 28 and then 12 to 20. So almost around 3 times down gearing. And not only does the wheel hub drive the scooter, the wheel of the scooter, it also has to support the weight. And the weight on the wheel hub might be more than half of that of the scooter and the rider, depending on where the rider, the person who's driving the scooter, is standing. So given that it's so many things crammed inside, I hope it will be able to support over 40 kilograms. And of course, we need 2 wheel hubs, one for each wheel. And regarding the wheels, next step is to assemble the wheels. But before doing that, I still need to design and print the 3D printed wheel covers, so they'll be kind of rounded, so the scooter can basically tilt when steering. And they will be, of course, as usual, made from TPU, which is a very flexible yet very strong material. So, next step, 3D printing. Okay, so let's talk about the wheels for the scooter. This is the first prototype I 3D printed, and had a big problem with this weird transition here. And I think this transition is also called the benchy hull line. It is the transition where the material switches from one thick wall to two walls. And I decided to redesign the geometry so that there are two walls from the very beginning. And this solved the issue of this weird transition. But the second prototype was way too soft. So for the second prototype, I decided to fix it by increasing the infill from 25% to 50%. And this is the final wheel with 50% infill and a nice texture to hide any kind of damage that might be visible when you're driving. And now it's time to assemble one of the wheels. So, after a lot of effort, I managed to put on the wheels and the 3D printed tires. And by effort, I mean it took so much effort to put this on, because I had to put each of these quarter circles, I had to put in place and push the axle through. And because there are just so many of them, I had to lubricate the axles and the axle holes in order to able to push the 16 stud axle through the entire wheel. And I had to do this 8 times for each wheel, so 16 times in total. And after these gears were on, so after the wheel itself was attached, I had to push the tire onto it. And it's funny because one of the tires went really smoothly, very soft, and the other one was much harder. So I decided the one that's slightly softer, I'm gonna put this one in the front because there's gonna be less weight there. So yes, the wheels are done. And for this one, I also put a bit of frame already on, so I can actually spin the wheel. It's hard to do it with one arm, but trust me, it can spin. So next thing to do is basically build the frame of the model.